Now, the next thing... You all right?
No, I'm fine.
Yeah. The next thing I want to have a look at is an extension of this, which is looking at a dream that you might have had. Have you done any dream work or dream analysis? Maybe here and there, yeah. Because a dream, particularly a recurring dream, will sort of tell you everything you want to know about you. Has anybody had any recurring dreams? Nobody's had any recurring dreams?
No.
You've had a recurring dream. Have you worked out the significance of it?
No.
Okay, and have you had it for a long time?
A few years.
Just in the recent past?
Yeah.
Would you like to find out what...
If possible, yeah.
Would you like to come and sit here? I don't know why I forgot your
name.
Anadine.
Yeah.
Now, again, we're not going to do any hypnosis, mm-hmm. but do you want to take your glasses off?
Okay, yeah.
Just want to close your eyes.
Okay.
Now, all you need to do is imagine that dream rather like a film that you're just running through in your own mind. As if you were running it through on a screen in front of you. Mm-hmm. From beginning to end. Can you do that?
Mm-hmm.
Can you run it through again? Maybe run it through a few times. Tell me when you get to the end of the film. Can you describe that film to me? That dream,
mm-hmm.
that recurring dream.
Mm-hmm. You seem to move into a house. And for some reason, I seem to think that it's in Wales because it's an old house. And it has a couple of sitting rooms, and we just use one most of the time. And in the other sitting room, there's lots of kind of antiques and things that was maybe personal to the person that owned the house before us. And I tend to kind of totally forget about the room for months and months at a time. And then something will remind me of, oh, if there's another room in the house. And also there's a barn, an outhouse. And there's an attic type thing or a granary in this barn, you know, like on two levels. And I know that I, in a dream, climbed up a ladder to get to the up into the loft of this barn, and then I found that I was up there, and I don't know how I managed to get from the ladder up into the barn because the ladder didn't quite go all the way up the wall, but I certainly couldn't come back down. There was no way I could make a connection with the ladder, and to jump down was really, really a long, long way. And in this particular dream where I was stuck up there, I seemed to remember a time that I was up there already before that this happened, and I did jump down, but this time I couldn't brave it and jump down. And I've dreamt about this house and this room a few times, and sometime then that I was having the dream again, I dreamt that I was in my daughter's bedroom and that she had taken one of these sort of antique type ornaments from that sitting room that we never really go into, and it was in her bedroom, and it made me remember that room again in the house, and that that stuff is in there, and some of it is covered over with white sheets and things like this, and just brings it back to me that, oh, there's that room in this house that we never go into. That's the dream, really, and I've had it a few times. And when I heard about Les's story and Tunisia, I was thinking, gosh, well, that's a dream for the future, because it's certainly not a house that I've ever been in. And it's nothing at all like the house we live in.
Mm-hmm. And anything else you would like to tell yourself about the dream?
Well, actually, just as I was going through it, telling you about it, and before I got to the point of telling you about my dream, and the last time I think I had the dream, I dreamt that about this ornament being in my daughter's room. And actually, what came to me there was, my daughter is 15. She's going to be 16 tomorrow. She just reminded me to my daughter.
Would you like to give me that feeling?
To what?
Would you like to give me that feeling?
Okay.
If I were to put my hand on your head, would that be all right?
Yeah.
Because you could then give me that feeling, and you could then perhaps understand a bit more about the dream, or about yourself, whatever is necessary for you to do. Okay? Would you like a tissue? There we go. So you just let that dream do whatever that dream needs to do. And if you need to talk to me, that's fine. But give me that feeling. Just keep giving it to me. Keep giving it to me. Give me a bit more. Some more? Yeah. Got some more to give to me. Keep doing it. Keep giving it to me until there's not a drop left.
keep giving it to them until there's not a drop more. Can I take my hand away now?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Just look to see if there's anything else you need to do. Just look to see whether there's something else you can extract from that dream.
I know is in stress is mention of my daughter's shoulders, and that's how I suppose getting away from me is to retreat from the room, and that's her sanctuary there, I guess.
Mm-hmm.
And I know she regulars the room and that kind of thing. Would even want me to knock on the door before I would knock on the door and the door was closed before I go in. A few evenings ago the door was about 6 inches open and she was just sitting on the bed and I was looking at clothes and washing her in. And I didn't knock because I seen her sitting on the bed. I just opened the door and was sitting on the bed and she just said, "Could you not knock?" That's right.
Give me that finger. It's okay to have that finger. Let it go. Maybe these tears have been wanting to come out for a long time now. Anything else you want to say?
Transition from them being children and very dependent on them to being adults and being independent, finding it very strange for myself, and feeling some bit isolated because I don't have to meet as much and so on.
What was it like for you when you were that age? When you were very little and very dependent? Before you became a teenager.
My mum had to go to work. My dad was very
temperamental stuff. Very controlling. I think if you had taught a daughter my